As heavy rains persist in Uganda, many roads have become impassable and unsafe for both motorists and pedestrians. In many parts of the country, roads are riddled with potholes. All have been completely washed away, leading to mobility challenges. While many would blame the poor roads on the shoddy works done by contractors, Ministry of Works and Transport officials, however, blame this on the lack of maintenance for the available roads.
One of the reasons why our roads are in such a poor state, almost on a continuous basis, is because of a poor maintenance routine. Okay? Of course, the construction of a road goes through a process. The first process is you do a design. You design a road. Design simply means you are able to determine how wide the road should be. You are able to determine the vertical and horizontal alignments so that motorists are comfortable while using it. And that design is transferred onto the ground, and somebody comes and builds it. I think most of the times the constructed road is constructed well, but eventually the roads get run off, you have potholes and so on and so forth. And that is mainly because of the maintenance.
Ronald Namungera, the manager for policy and strategy at the Uganda Road Fund, reveals that they are currently faced with a funding shortfall for road maintenance. The ministry needs at least 1.6 trillion shillings every year to carry out maintenance on all roads in the country.
So what we get for maintenance as Uganda Road Fund is about 400 billion per annum. And this 400 billion is supposed to be shared between KCCA, UNRA, and the 135 districts, plus the 31 municipalities. So if you look at the people who are sharing this money, definitely the money is not enough to do maintenance of these roads. At Road Fund, through our calculations, we note that we need about 1.6 trillion per year to maintain our roads in a perfect and good condition. But of that 1.6, we get about 400 billion. See, if you calculate the figure, we get about 20 to 30% of what we need. So that explains why you'll find that most of the roads, either in the city or in the districts, are not well maintained. So the money for maintenance is still little.
On the other hand, the State Minister for Works and Transport blames the poor roads on the unlicensed engineers that are taking on public projects. The Engineers Registration Board now seeks to make it compulsory for all engineering graduates to be fully registered and licensed by the board before taking on any big projects. Only 1,800 engineers out of over 25,000 graduate engineers are licensed.
That my ministry, working with the Minister of Finance, must come up with a local content policy, a deliberate policy of developing local content with the view to phasing out the so-called foreign companies slowly. So it is work in progress. There are so many things to be looked into, including some of the things you're touching. The competence of the engineers, yes, they graduate, but after graduating, how prepared are they? Because now, like what you see happening in the country, and it is until I met these people when I came to the ministry that reality shook me to waking up. You find everybody in the site calling himself an engineer with a reflector. Everybody is calling himself or herself an engineer. You find people undertaking projects like the construction of Crescent Towers. But if you look at the character who is supervising such a construction, could be a graduate of Elgon Technical Mbale.
Meanwhile, the engineers across the country are set to celebrate the International Engineering Day on March 4th, 2024, under the theme Engineering Solutions for a Sustainable World. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.